So I think we fly to about 15 destinations across the Greek islands. And it's increasingly popular for us, as is Cyprus. What we're trying to do with Greece and Cyprus and our other destinations is extend the flying program for those into the winter months. Now, we already have a winter flying program down to Cyprus. We'd like to build that up further. We don't do much flying down to the Greek islands in the winter. Of course, we fly to Athens year-round, but that's a different type of destination. Very strong business demand for Athens, very strong demand for people visiting friends and relatives. What we want to do is bring tourists to the Greek islands across the winter months, which I think is fantastic for the tourism industry. It's fantastic for the airports, and it's good for EasyJet as well. But also, it's fantastic for the consumer, because those are fantastic destinations year in, year out. Cyprus is a great example of what we can do in the winter. We fly to Larnaca, we fly to Paphos year round, and we need to work with the tourism authorities in Cyprus to build up our capacity in the winter.
As far as Greece is concerned, which is your market share? And the second thing I would like to ask is, how do you see Ryanair, which is your biggest opponent and has adopted the same policy as you do?
So what we focus on is our own business. We are told by our passengers that they are really happy with the product that EasyJet provides. They love our excellent punctuality, they love our network, they love our onboard product. We don't spend too much time thinking about what the competition are doing. What we really focus on is delivering what the passengers want. And what our passengers are telling us with Greece actually is they want more. They want more destinations, they want to go to more new interesting islands, and they want to do that with great low fares. And one of the things that we are doing is working with the airport authority, and I know that there is a transition taking place in Egypt in terms of the ownership of airports. We're working with the airport authority to make sure the costs remain low to those Greek airports, and therefore the consumer will continue availing themselves of low fares. We're also working with the tourism authorities to ensure that they support, in particular they support flights that are at beginning and the end of the summer and over the winter, because that's what we need their support. That's something that we're focused on.
Your market share?
So our market share in Greece, I believe, is around 15%. We'll have to come back to you for precise numbers.
And your goals for your estimations for 2016?
So I would expect to see that increase. We have a significant operation in Athens, for example. Athens is one of our biggest destinations in Greece. We operate twice a day from Gatwick, and we're always growing our presence in Greece. So I think it's important to make the point that EasyJet, of course, doesn't just fly to Greece from the UK. We fly from across Europe. When we open a new base, we're always looking at new destinations that we fly to in Greece and Cyprus. So recently, actually, we've built our portfolio of destinations in Cyprus. We've added Milan in recent years. We've looked at destinations in Switzerland, we've had Basel, for example. So we're really growing Cyprus and Greece from around Europe. One of the things with Cyprus is it's traditionally been a very strong destination for the British consumer. Now, as an airline, EasyJet knows that it's a fantastic product. It's a fantastic place to visit. We are helping, what we're helping, I guess, to the central tourism industry with, is launching that product across Europe. So getting people in Italy and in Germany and in Switzerland interested in flying to Cyprus, that's something that we can really do well.
From Cyprus,
so we're also flying growing the capacity in the existing cities that we have. We've had a really strong summer in terms of demand for flights across our network. We are, as a business, growing at 7 or 8% a year, and I would expect that growth to be mirrored, at least that level of growth to be mirrored to Cyprus. In terms of new destinations, I don't have anything that I can reveal today, I'm afraid, but it's something that we're always looking at. And as a hint for you, EasyJet will generally operate from airports where it has based aircraft. So when you look at where we're operating, where we're opening new bases across Europe, then those are the most likely points in which we'll be launching new services to Greece and Cyprus.
What's your opinion concerning the privatization of the Greek airports, regional airports?
It's something that we're watching very closely. I think the really important thing for us all to consider in this process is that costs remain low. Now, the Greek tourism industry has been very successful over the years with the cost structure that we currently have at Greek airports. We're working very closely with our partners in Greece and across Europe to ensure that message is delivered to the potential new owners of the airports, infrastructure at Greek airports has to be affordable level. And my colleagues are working very closely with potential bidders and not in a position to see anymore. But what we need to see is that cost environment remain as low as possible.
Are you optimistic or not?
Am I optimistic?
No. Are you optimistic or not?
I'm not close enough to comment in detail on that.
Okay, are there any plans for Greece to increase capacity or at the new destinations?
I mean, what always astounds me is how many beautiful destinations there are in Greece. You know, year after year, I think we have found all of the airports, we've found all of the fantastic resorts, we've found all of the niche destinations, but every year Mountain comes to us and we found something new and exciting. We added Vetsa to the network recently. But a number of new destinations in Greece. Hania, for example, is relatively new. Every year, our customers are telling us about exciting new destinations they want to fly to. So I wouldn't be at all surprised to see us adding more points in the Greek map for EasyJet. We're growing as a company by about 7 or 8% per year, and I would expect Greece to get more than its fair share of that. Mm-hmm.